So welcome to today's maths class. Today we'll do percentage and its application. Our learning objectives are ratio and percentage, profit and loss, discount, sale tax or value added tax. First is ratio and percentage. Ratio means comparing two quantities. Ratio ka matlab two quantities ko compare karna. The comparison can also be done using the percentage. A basket has 45 apples and 30 oranges. Then the ratio of number of apples to the number of orange, that is 45:30. Simplest form mein change karenge, that is 3:2. It is read as 3:2. Next is order of terms. That is very important in ratio. Means 3:2. That is not same as 2:3. So the ratio of the number of oranges to number of apples, that is 30:45, that is 2:3. This comparison can also be done using percentage. Total number of fruit, 45 + 30, that is 75. Then there are 45 apples out of total 75 fruit. Clear? Now out of 75 fruit, number of apples, that is 45. So out of 100 fruit, the number of apple, 45/75 × 100, that is 60. Percentage of apple plus percentage of orange, that is 100. So percentage of apple, that is 60, plus percentage of orange, that is 100. So percentage of orange kitni ho jayegi, 100 - 60, that is 40. Thus the basket have 60% apple and 40% oranges. This is the comparison of two type of fruits by percentage. If you ask to convert the ratio to percentage, simply multiply by 100%. So 1 = 100/100, 3/4 × 100%, that is 75%. Next is percentage, fractions and decimals. Percentage and decimals are also fraction. Percentage is always with the denominator 100, while decimals are the denominator 10, 100, 1000 or so on, but written in different way. Percentage means per 100. 25% means 25 of every 100, or simply 25/100. For the symbol of percentage, this is the symbol of percentage. We can write 1/100. To change a percentage to fraction, we write it in a fraction with the denominator 100 and simplify. Usko kya karte hai? Simplify it possible. To change it to the decimal, change the fractions obtained to a decimal. For example, 30/100. So that is equals to 3/10. 0 se 0 cancel ho gaya, 3/10, that is equals to 0.3. So here we have changed into decimal. To change the fraction and decimal to percentage, multiply by 100, like 0.45. So we'll convert to percentage. For that we'll multiply by 100, that is equals to 45%. To find a percentage of a quantity, change the percentage to fraction or the decimal to multiply it by quantity. For example, 20% of 200. So 200 multiplied by 20/100, that is equals to ₹40. Clear? Next is percentage increase and decrease. First, to increase a quantity. To increase a quantity by percent, find the percentage of the quantity and add it to the original quantity. For example, increase of ₹150 by 30%. So 30% of 150, we'll find out, that is 45. So we'll add it to 150, that is equals to ₹195. Clear? Next is to decrease the quantity. To decrease the quantity by the percentage, find the percentage of the quantity and subtract it from the original price. For example, decrease of ₹400 by 20%. So first we'll find out what is the 20% of 400, that is ₹80. Now we'll subtract from 400. So that is equals to ₹320. Clear? Next, find one quantity as the percentage of the other. So methods are, write the two quantities as a fraction and multiply by 100%. Now we'll take an example here. Write 30 cm as the percentage of 1 m 20 cm. So 1 m 20 cm, first we'll convert into centimeter, that is 120 cm. Now required percentage kya ho jayegi? We have to express 30 cm as a percentage of 120 cm. So 30/120 × 100, that is equals to 25%. Clear? Next is exercise 9.1. Find the ratio of the following 50 paisa to rupees 10. So first the quantity should be in same unit. So 50 paisa and 10 rupees will convert into paisa. So that is equals to 10 into 100. That is equals to 1000 paisa. Now ratio 50 upon 1000. So 1:20. Clear? So you have to practice all the questions of this exercise. Next is profit and loss. Amount at which an object is bought is known as its cost price or CP. Jis amount pe kisi cheez ko kharidte hai, that is known as cost price or CP. The cost price include overhead expenses, extra expenses done after the purchase and before the sale, like transportation, labor charges, repair, etc. All these are included in cost price. Amount at which an object is sold, that is known as selling price or SP. When the selling price is more than the cost price, the shopkeeper have profit. So profit equals to SP minus CP, and SP equals to CP plus profit. When the selling price is less than the cost price, that means shopkeeper is having loss. So loss equals to CP minus SP, and SP equals to CP minus loss. Clear? Next, some formulas. Gain, that is equals to SP minus CP. Loss, CP minus SP. Gain percentage, gain upon CP into 100. Loss percentage, loss upon CP into 100%. To find the SP, MN, CP and gain percentage, all loss percentage are given. So SP equals to 100 plus gain percentage upon 100 into CP, and SP equals to 100 minus loss percentage upon 100 into CP. To find the CP, when SP and gain percentage and loss percentage are given. So CP ho jayegi 100 upon 100 plus gain percentage into SP, and CP equals to 100 upon 100 minus loss percentage into SP. Next, know it. The gain or the loss is always knocked on the cost price. Gain or loss percentage ko hamesha cost price pe calculate karte. Overhead refer to extra cost incurred by the buyer on the item bought before the selling it to the customer. Real cost, that is equals to cost price plus overhead. Now we'll take an example here. A milkman sold 2 of his cows for rupees 20,000 each. On one, he made the gain of 5% and other, he made the loss of 10%. Find the overall gain or loss. So, CP of the first cow. Here, what we have given? Sold means each ki price is 20,000 and gain percentage is loss percentage is given. So, we have to find CP. CP equals to 100 upon 100 plus profit percentage into SP. So, we will find out the CP of the first cow. Now CP of the second cow, 100 upon 100 minus loss percentage is SP. So this is the CP of second cow. So combine karenge, total CP will find out. So total CP jo hamari aa jayegi, that is this. Now combine SP 20,000 plus 20,000, because each ka price tha 20,000. So that is equals to 40,000. Now, as you know, here CP is greater than SP. That means loss ho raha hai. So loss equals to CP minus SP. So CP mein se SP subtract karenge, so we'll get the loss. So this is the loss. 1269.53/63. That is the loss. Clear? Practice all the examples here. Next is exercise 9.2. Find the SP when CP is given and loss percentage is given. So SP equals to 100 minus loss percentage upon 100 into CP. So here 100 minus loss percentage, that is 4 upon 100 into CP, that is 5600. So 100 minus 4, that is 96 upon 100 into. So SP, that is equals to 96 into 56, that is equals to rupees 5376 rupees. Clear? Next is discount. Discount, what is discount? Discount is a reduction given on the mark price by the shopkeeper. First is mark price. The printed price or the text price on an article, that is called mark price. It is also called list price. Next is net price. The selling price at which an article is sold to the customer after deducting the discount from the mark price, that is called net price. Net price kya hoga? Jo mark price hai, so discount nikalne ke baad jo price bachegi, that is the net price. Rate of discount, discount percentage, discount upon MP into 100%, SP equals to MP minus discount, SP equals to MP into 100 minus discount percentage upon 100, mark price 100 into SP upon 100 minus discount percentage. Next, we'll take an example here. Find the rate of discount when MP is rupees 800 and SP 640 rupees. So here, mark price is 800 and selling price is 640. So discount 800 minus 640, 160 rupees. Rate of discount, discount upon MP into 100, 160 upon 800 into 100, that is 20%. That is the discount. Next is sale tax or value added tax. We pay sale tax when we buy item. The sale tax is charged by the government on the sale of an item. It is collected by the shopkeeper from the customer and deposited in the sale tax department of the government. Sale tax is always calculated on the selling price of an item and added to the bill amount. So sale tax equals to kya ho jayega? That is equals to tax percentage of bill amount. These days, the price include the tax known as value-added tax. Nowadays, it is called VAT or value-added tax. Example samajhte hain? The price of a washing machine is rupees 13,000. So sale tax charge on it, that is rate of 12%. Find the amount that the customer will have to pay to the buyer. So sale tax charge ho jayega 12% of 13,000. So that is equals to rupees 1,560. Now amount kya pay karna padega? Sale price jo hai plus the tax. So that equals to 13,000 plus 1,560, that is 14,560 rupees. Clear? Next is exercise 9.3. An item marked at rupees 840 and sold it for 714. What is the discount and discount percentage? So discount ho jayega, that is mark price 840 minus selling price, that is 714. So that is equals to rupees 126. Now we have to find the discount percentage. So that is equals to discount upon mark price into 100. So that is equals to 15%. Clear? Next is summary. Percent means per 100. The price at which an article is bought, that is called the cost price or CP. The price at which an article is sold, that is known as selling price or SP. The profit is made when selling price of an article is more than its cost price. The loss is made when the selling price of an article is less than the cost price. The printed price on the article is called the mark price or MP. The deduction allowed on the mark price, that is called discount. Next is multiple choice questions. Take the correct option. 25% of rupees 600. So 600 ka 25% we have to find out. ₹150. So A is the correct option here. So here we end the chapter. I hope aap sabko chapter achhe samajh mein aa gaya hoga. Now you have to practice it.